Waven SketchUp interface tutorial. So Waven is a room acoustic simulation software based on geometrical acoustics, which was already started a couple of years ago. And at some stage we decided to also include a SketchUp interface because we thought it would be convenient to directly modify the geometry and the scenery and get live updates from a room acoustic simulation engine. So you probably have installed already SketchUp, and when you start up SketchUp, and Waven unfortunately only works with some older versions of it, so I have here SketchUp Make 2016, it also works for the older version, 2015, but not for the most recent releases, because the API substantially changed and we are a little bit behind with updating this. So what you need to do when after you've installed the Waven or the ETA simulation environment, you need to go to Window Preferences, and then here select Extensions, scroll down a bit, and there you find the ACCD Waven Exporter. Just have to click this once. Sorry. The other part, the acoustic animation, is not relevant for the tutorial, but you can also activate this. So let's have a look at the tutorial. Step one basically just explains the program, so you obviously need to use SketchUp. And then we have different parts and applications using the Waven libraries, so that's a SketchUp visualizer, SketchUp auralization. Then we also have an old Waven GUI, which is not part of this tutorial, and also the SketchUp interface uses the Waven console application, which is the main simulation core, which is used for command line based operation, and that's also used if you use different interfaces such as the MATLAB or MATLAB interface, for example. So step two is already creating a room model. I will go through this very quickly. So we'll draw a rectangular, which is 12 by 20 meters, and I'm going to pull this up by 5 meters. Then I'm already applying some materials. I'm using here plaster to put this on all walls, and I will reverse it because textures only have to apply it from the inside. And for the ceiling, I will do it, undo the step, and we'll put some acoustic ceiling. So those acoustic materials here, they are the only ones which are connected to acoustical absorption and scattering data. So that's why for acoustic simulation, you're only supposed to use them. So I will hide this one, and market on the ground, so we have our first one already. And the second and the third step of the tutorial, we are supposed to modify this room a bit to make a real theater or lecture hall arrangement. So, almost too high, let's put it 3 meters. And then it goes somewhere like this. Third step, we are situation. We have room with a sound source in there, but we also obviously need to have receivers. That's the sixth step, and the fifth step is also setting some simulation parameters. So if we just want to evaluate room acoustic parameters, we are using the so-called tool SketchUp Visualizer, or short SUV here. Going to start up this. So when we started, we're going to restart this. As soon as we have simulation, we can also save the room models, and we will also we'll do it once more under a different name. That was just took a while until it showed up. The simulation results are also stored in this file. You save your SketchUp file and model for the next time, and you still see the old values for your last simulation step. Now we are looking at step number 8. This is about the visualization of ray tracing particles, and this is not really for an acoustic practical evaluation, but it's more like a validation process if your model is really watertight. This is a rather simple model, but for a more complex model, you have to make sure that there are no updates in there. So, now, updates this. Now we have this hole here, and we've repeated the simulation. We see now we're losing waves here, and this is not really that doesn't work out for the simulation engine. We need to have a watertight model, especially because also like processes like boom pulse synthesis requires a certain room volume. And here we could still say, okay, this is a, we take that room volume. But like if we have an open theater, for example, that would work. So if you really would have an open window in your model and you want to model this, then you have to describe this like by a surface which is closed. I have to deactivate it. I'll refresh it. And now put a material here which has 100% absorption. So that's something you can like model by yourself. Just you can even just use a color. Absorber, and that then you can change all values here to 100%. Blue curve is a scattering curve, and in this way you can also design an absorber, like an open area of your model. But that was not part of the tutorial, so I'm going to delete this window again. Okay, there we go. And that's an important remark. Always make sure that materials are only assigned to the interior surface. So I can also demonstrate that, like, for example, if we put for our ceiling, if we put here the material on the other side, so I'm going to reverse it now, the acoustic ceiling is pointing outwards, and now we are losing our waves in that direction. Histogram plot. that always opens in the background, or the Schroeder curve plot. Yeah. And then you can see the average values of all positions. This energy Schroeder curve is just for the front left, for the first position here. So that's not an average across all positions. And what you then can do, and that's also part of the tutorial later on, you can repeat simulations and see how your values change. I think it's always best if you arrange your windows like this. And now on the bottom right, you see how we have differences between one simulation to the other. So what we actually want to do is we want to reduce stochastical uncertainty, because, well, there's stochastic elements in that simulation, but we want to get rid of them because we want to have a stable, reliable result. So what we always can do is we can increase particle numbers. So if we set this to a very high value, let's say at 200,000, and we will repeat the simulation, then we obviously have to wait a bit more. But we will also observe that values are still changing, but not a lot. Especially like integral parameters such as 12, they show a fairly constant value. One more. Change at all. RT30 might change a bit, but when we have variations in the lower end, then this regression of the version time evaluation might lead to slightly different values, but at the end we want to be somewhere with variation of less than 10 or 5% between simulations. Okay, that was that. Here it's also another example with also changing the environmental settings. And here we went to the 4 kHz frequency band. That's something you can do on your own. That's something I talked about just now, the stochastical variation, varying the number of particles. That also goes a bit further, and you're varying the temporal resolution. And now we're going at the step where we can modify also raw materials. So what we can do is, in general, just remember those reverb times here. We can use the plain bucket and use completely different materials. For example, we will put some curtains into the room. Actually, putting some more here. So now I'm repeating the simulation, and please remember those values and see how they change after we finish the simulation. So that's a big change. We add a lot of absorption to the room, and that's why our reverb time substantially dropped. So here we see at 1 kHz we have 0.56 of absorption, so 56% of the energy is absorbed for each reflection. And when we compare this to the plaster with the crystal level of the back wall, there we only had 9%, so there's a big difference. And those surfaces take up a lot of the overall surface of the room. I just mentioned it before, we can also change completely, come up with new materials and design them and save them in our model. But we can also just modify them if we like. So if we say, okay, now our curtain even got better or like thicker and has more absorption, or we can adjust it in that way. And we can repeat the simulation. Have to wait again, and we'll open the Schroeder curve. And now we even have it's a very dry environment, more like potentially a cinema now. state. So let's take some drive state again. And we run this. We should get back to our reverb time of 1.5 seconds. Okay, and now we are going at the step where we say, okay, now we want to compare this to the more traditional approach of room acoustics prediction or reverberation time prediction. So here you've probably noticed there's a button T to calculate the reverb time. So this calculates the reverberation time according to the I-ring equation. So I can press now update. So it also says there's absorption data available for all materials, and now we have here the equivalent absorption area for the different frequency bands. We have the air absorption contribution to this equivalent absorption area. So we see this exceeds the absorption of the surfaces for the higher frequency bands, or like for the highest at least, also leading to a very low overall reverb time. One important thing is, in order to calculate the I-ring reverberation times, this model needs to be grouped. So now we have a group here, we can easily edit it, so that's why you're supposed to explode it afterwards once more. So this still stays a group, this audience area, but now we have here individual elements of the model. Okay. Next step, we also are interested obviously in listening to this room, and for that we can easiest is to delete this audience area, and we can place another sound source, but we're going to place a receiver. So that's a binaural receiver, so that's something, a dummy receiver with 2 ears. Set, then we can actually export this project also as a so-called RPF file. So when you go here to Raven Exporter, you first are supposed to export the geometry. We'll just put it on the desktop now. And then I can export sources, receiver, and settings. Also exports material characteristics. Also, if you've modified any data, it asks you if you should override the Raven database. So in this case, that's fine. I modified some curves, but that's okay for now. So here I can folder in my Raven input folder and put the RPF file in there. And this file has now a clear definition of the scene, and we can work with that later also for connection with other interfaces. So I put this Raven input tutorial, and I can open this here. And here a lot of simulation settings I included there. Here's the path to our model file. And sound source positions, receiver positions, and then a lot of settings for the simulation, ray tracing parameters, as well as the image source parameters. And that can be, for example, then it'll be loaded in MATLAB, systematically varied. And we can, for example, run a simulation for changing simulation configurations or scene settings, for example, varying the temperature or something, very systematically repeat the simulation. And then evaluate results. Okay, that was. If you have exported this RPF file, then you can later on use this also with a MATLAB tutorial. That was described here. But we can also directly do an auralization in here for the situation. So from sound source to receiver, we just click on the binaural pulse response simulation here, the result folder automatically opens up. Here we see a folder containing the binaural boom pulse response and a folder combining the, including the mono pulse response, but also the individual parts. So that's just the image source result, and that's just the ray tracing result of the binaural boom pulse response. This can be now convolved with an anechoic audio stimulus. We can here say a source input, and then we can select from a range. But you could use any anechoic recordings you have. Here I will just choose a language, and I will click the button. And it will do the convolution with the binaural boom pulse response. And
in language, infinitely many words can be written with a small set of letters.
And that will automatically play back with your default audio player. So what you then can do is now you can modify the position, get a bit closer to the stage, rewind the simulation, and listen to the situation once more.
In language, infinitely many words can be written with a small set of letters.
What we can also do is we can get, I'm going to go back to the lower to the seats in the back, and now modify the room once more. Put some absorption in there. Just to give you another audible impression of it. So it's already on the convolution again.
In language, infinitely many words can be written with a small set of letters.
And now we're back to the cinema movie theater situation with a lot of absorption around. Okay, you've probably noticed that in the organization folders, you also have seen that there's always a combination, like saying all sources. So what you can do is you can also place a second sound source, and we can select some other short. Let's just take a cello playing there. Also do is I'm going to rotate the sound source now, because I actually want to also apply as a characteristic. So we can select here the directivity, we can also select a violin. We just did a cello, right? So let's take a cello. And so this is now an omnidirectional speech source, but we can also put a speaker directivity is a singer, so it takes us, and then we simulate this once more. For two sound sources, it will take a bit longer, but not too long. So there is a second source, and pulse response for less opening. We don't need this, so we can now simulate the situation. So now we've listened to a speech and a violin, a cello in this room at the same time. This is obviously not a mixing tool, that's why I also have you have both tracks available, so if you want to do something with it later on. When you adjust levels, then you have to go to your digital audio workstation and come up with a final mix. Okay, that was the step 17. Then we have some more steps. Step 17 here for the real-time audio simulation. That's not something I'm going to demonstrate in here. because this will require ASIO for all drivers, or ASIO drivers in general, and that's a bit more difficult to record it, and I'm not doing this now with OBS Studio, so that's why this is not included. But here you can actually go one step further and navigate through with this, for example, with this move tool, we can walk around the sound sources and listen to the acoustics in real time of this one. That's possible with this SUA application, but this does not work in parallel to the video recording of the session. All right, that was it for my introduction to the tutorial. I hope it works out for you and you will be able to simulate what you have intended or demonstrate what you have intended. Thanks for watching, and let me know if there are any questions.